Greetings everyone, and welcome to another World War Z video guide. Today we're running Horde mode hard to see some tactics and some things we can do in order to reach at least 20 waves, complete them, in order to get an insane amount of XP and blue coins. Because I saw in some comments that people prefer to do that, which I don't recommend. It's very tiring, very time consuming, but some people may need to invest, I don't know, one and a half hour per day or a little more than close to 2 hours to just do that and get rest. So I to understand, I will do this video for this reason, to help you apply the best defenses, the best tactics in order to just maximize our chances to reach wave 20 or more. I'm running with a fixer class, although it's leveled up, I haven't purchased any perks, so I don't gain any advantage. I will never use a supply bag. I'm just demonstrating that you can do these tactics with any class. Because I have leveled already all the other classes at full levels, 5 prestige. So we're going to go with the fixer. But this tactic applies to every other class, except the fixer, surprisingly, that he can take advantage with the supply bag and just use whatever weapon we want. That's a plus thing. But with all the other classes, we're going with the advanced combat weapon. We will explain later why. In order to basically use the least amount of ammo crates. So that's it, let's start with a level. And honestly, I have made another guide up to wave 13, which I recommend to do because it requires 30 minutes or 40 depending on your luck, and you get an insane amount of XP and it's not as tiring. So we're going to begin from the terminal. And this for this guide, in order to avoid to have a video 2 hours long, I'm going to skip all the actual waves until wave 10 because it's honestly very easy. But I'm going to show you what type of defenses I apply in between waves. And from wave 11, when things start to get a little more hectic, I will show you the complete video because this is a live recording. I'm actually doing things as I record them. And I will just keep explaining things. So sometimes I will talk a little fast, sometimes I may do things a little faster, but I will do my best to try to make it as more comprehensive as possible so you can just follow up. For starters, we're going to find the breaching charge. I was hanging outside, here's the first breaching charge location, because as soon as you enter here, the timer starts and we have around 2 minutes to apply defenses. We're going to run fast to find the first breaching charge. Here's another second location for the breaching charge, because we need to gather as many resources as we can, because we're going for 20 waves plus. And make things easier, here is another location for the breaching charge on the lap of this poor soldier. Here is the fourth location for the breaching charge. Yeah, it's not visible sometimes, you have to jump the fence. And I'm going to show you the last location for the breaching charge, although we find it here. In worst case scenario, if you don't find it here, it's definitely inside this area, on the bottom of the shelf. Open the door. Here is actually the breaching charge location. Let's go outside and okay, we need to make sure none of the bots is inside the from the other side of the door. Otherwise, they will open it. So for the first defenses, I will just save some time, begin the battle. Don't bother with the lurker, 3 bots will deal with him. So we're going to apply 2 Voltage crits. But this is my personal, let's say, thing. You can also take your time to apply an ammo box here. That's the 3 defenses you need. But for the first wave, I'm going to make an exception and show it to you. Because usually I can make it with this weapon without using the supply bag or any other thing. I'm killing the Z-cats, they are closer. It's more efficient this way. And it's also a good guide for people that are using shotguns. You can just kill them when they're here. But if you have the longer range, you can just shoot a couple of shots. And actually the scout rifle is one of the best weapons to start and kill the Zeke. You definitely can do this with a scout rifle. The most challenging weapons you start is the SMG. You see, in order to hit the Zeke, I'm changing the shoulder, and you don't have to stand so close to the voltage grid, it's a little risky in later waves. But anyway, as I was saying, the SMG is more challenging. Okay, good screamer. Just drops, my favorite thing of the screamers. You shoot him once and they drop. Oh no, I hear the the gas bags actually are the worst. What are you doing, Alois? They will have to kill the bulls and the Zeke before they come to the voltage grid, otherwise they will break it. And sometimes gas packs drop from there here, making the defense very difficult. So these are the challenges. Now, we're never going to restock this weapon because we immediately will buy tier 3 weapons. We need to do this 3 times for some reasons. Oh, this is going to be a good run. I don't want to jinx it because we found the advanced combat weapon from the first. You see, once we bought the tier 3 weapon, Raul just upgraded to an assault shotgun, where the other bots still have the tier 1 weapon. If we buy this 2 more times, all the bots will have tier 3 weapons, which, believe me, will make a huge difference on the kill count, and the bots will help you quite a lot. Especially since now this is going to be hopefully a good run. There are some variables to be a good run. First, we need to find the advanced combat weapon on the first 3 times we buy the tier 3 weapons. I'm going to actually use the bullpup rifle for the simple reason because I'm not going to resupply it and save some ammo. But I'm going to anyway add the ammo crate here just in case I need it. So the other variables is what type of tier 3 weapons your bots have. A assault shotgun is actually very good. The worst options are the SMG. It doesn't have decent range and they do so few kills with it. So these are good. The battle rifle is good. And now it depends on what type of challenges you get. Don't die or become decapitated. It's very decent. So be right back for wave 3 to see what defenses we apply. Okay, we're going for wave 3 defenses. Do not forget to pick up your full tier 3 weapon before we buy the next one. And let's see, you see now Eloise has a tier 3 battle rifle, thanks to that. We need to buy it one more time, but we're not going to do that. We're going to apply some good defenses because now we need to invest a little in meat or defenses after wave 3 or 4. So the second voltage grid downstairs is actually very helpful. And we're also going to apply an auto turret, a soy medkit, but I will take it. An auto turret here. It's very important to have it and restock it. It actually covers our blind spot down here and will make a difference. And yeah, I will take the medkit. Have your eyes open to pick up medkits. There are certain locations to find medkits, heavy weapons. Supply bag here. Sometimes you can find things here. And in between waves, sometimes you won't have the time. Sometimes you can find here. If you have the time, do it. If you don't do it. Now, because I have the time, I will also do something else. I apply an ammo crate here and on the other side there. For the simple reason, in between the waves, I'm not going to resupply from here. I'm going to resupply from there to save time and do not need to reapply another ammo crate here. Probably until wave 20, we can be good. So be right back for defenses for wave 4. Oh, we're going for wave 4. A freaking gas bag just dropped from here. You see, that's why I hate the gas bags. A drop here. Anyway, be careful. Now we're going to buy a tier 3 weapon for the last time because we have already the best tier 3 weapon. And damn it. Advanced SMG. Okay, never mind. Ooh, we can actually save some ammo. I will restock here. And use for the wave 4 the crossbow, which is the exception we can do. Crossbow is actually not bad until wave 4. You can do it, otherwise it's very, very bad after that, especially for solo, the worst weapon you can use. One other tip, always carry a voltage grid in between waves in case this or this vault upgrade fails, so you can replace it immediately, just to in case to invest in something else. Usually this is true for the hardest waves, wave 15, 16, something like that. So anyway, be right back because we're getting unlucky with our achievements. I cannot kill 25 Zeke with fire with this setup, so be right back for defenses for wave 5. After the swarm is over, be careful to kill the bulls. If you leave the bull here, it will break your voltage grid and just burn throughout your defenses. So we can just use the advanced combat weapon from now on. In wave 5, I do like to do something to save some time in order to be able to search for the breaching charge. Because after wave 5, we are going to relocate here. So we're going to apply the defenses we need. Hopefully you have done another, let's say, in-between achievement, which I didn't. I wasn't lucky apart from the first one. So I'm still at very low points. Usually I could have now 100 more at least. Don't worry about it. Things considering are quite good. We don't have to buy tier 3 weapons more an extra time, because in case you don't find a advanced combat weapon, you have to pay more and buy the tier 3 weapons. Without the advanced combat weapon, you are going to waste so much ammo for the ammo crates, and you won't be able to keep up for the last waves. So you save a lot of, actually, let's say, ammo if you buy and find advanced combat weapon. I'm just going here because I have the time to search for some heavy weapons hidden in the map. Oh, a medkit. We already have a medkit. I'm not going to use it. For the first ways, I'm a little stingy with my resources. Unless we're very low health, we don't have to do it. If you don't want to risk it, you can do it. But personally, you can. It's a low risk up to wave 10 if you are at this health. So I'll be right back for defenses for wave 6. Okay, now we're going for wave 6. We're closing the doors because we're going for the long run. Hello, Lurker, my old friend. We're going to resupply from here, actually. And we're going to apply defenses now on the back. After wave 5, before wave 6, we have to invest the defenses on the back. Definitely auto turrets. We apply 3 auto turrets that have a visibility of the gate, because this way, in case the Zeke just run by us, this turret can shoot the Zeke. This turret can also shoot the Zeke, and the most important, this one will shoot the Zeke. As you saw, I haven't yet bought reinforcements, because you have 4 soldiers. Since 2 are alive, after wave 11, 12, then I want to invest more for the soldiers. Now I just believe 2 soldiers and the auto turrets are more than enough. But we're also going to invest auto turrets for here. We don't have to do it for the first wave. 3 auto turrets in behind are okay. We're going to run to search for the lurker, not the lurker, the breaching charge. Here's the first location. Come outside, guys. Usually I don't want to close the doors, but for the first ways I do. Sometimes you may find C4 in the shelves. But I also come here in order to see what supplies we get. A medkit inside here. And found a heavy weapon. Supply bags are useless for me. Here you can also find a breaching charge. There you are, my breaching charge. We don't have the time to breach the door. But I'm going to show you other locations for the breaching charge. For this location, it's here, in the shelves here, and upstairs a couple of locations. But I'm going to buy a second ammo crate if I've already applied one. I haven't applied none. But yeah, we definitely need an ammo crate because we have the advanced combat weapon. And continuing to defenses for wave 7 as well, for 2 locations for breaching charge, which this is one. I'm going to show you the other. As you see, I haven't resupplied because we're going to apply the ammo box downstairs. This is the last location for the breaching charge. We're going to apply the ammo box downstairs. Here you are, Lurker. entries apply in between waves. This way, we will have more ammo for the upstairs. And now in wave 7, we can breach a door and apply defenses on the back. Or this side, because this side needs extensive, let's say, care. And you need to apply 2 voltage grids and 2 auto turrets. Otherwise, things can get very messy, especially after wave 13-14. Thankfully, we have done some of the achievements and we have more than enough points. Come inside, guys. Come inside, please. Thank you very much. And we definitely need the auto turrets for starters. And then we need to apply 2 voltage grids here and 2 auto turrets, which is the best investment. So many Zeke are going to get past you for this side that the auto turrets, the voltage grids will make a huge difference. We don't have the time, unfortunately, to apply everything. But thankfully, up to wave 7-8, you don't actually have to invest some more. And we also have the 3 auto turrets and 2 guards. I'm going to just take the voltage grid. No. Just take something else. Stationary machine gun, when we have enough points, we're going to use it just in case we get, let's say, the achievement. We need to kill 100 Zeke with a stationary machine gun and get 100 points. So invest 6 points, 60, to die something. So be right back for defenses for wave 8. And moving on, 4 more defenses. Thankfully, some Iron resources. I'm a little glad. Now we have to apply the defenses on the back, just so you. If you buy a wrong defense, you can do what I did. You can just buy another defense if you have enough points, and it will replace or refund the difference, so you don't have to worry. Unless you have exactly the same amount of required, let's say, amount of credits, then you have to wait. Now, because we have so many credits, we're going to invest a little more defenses here. This is the worst case scenario that I very rarely use, but I highly recommend to do. In worst case scenario, sometimes the gate may be attacked, especially for the side. You may need to run back and hell can break loose. So we need to be ready to have supplies in order to resupply our ammo. And 2 voltage grids, because without the voltage grids, if you come back here, even with all the bots, it's basically suicide. So 2 voltage grids to just help us. And the ammo. That will make a huge difference for the defense in the back. And we're going to start applying some other defenses that are, let's say, will not take so much advantage now. But later, for example, these voltage grids will be very important. This one. For later waves, which we won't have time to apply them. That's why when we have the time, we do that. I hear the lurker, not here. And we'll also need on the later waves to apply barbed wires, but I don't want to confuse you, so be right back for defenses for wave 9. I want to show something in between the waves. If you can, I will just kill some Zeke. If you can do it, you can try it. You can see the screamer where it is. If you just, with the advanced combat weapon, you can kill him like this. So that's another thing. I'll be right back. And back again for defenses for wave 9. We need to apply the second ammo box from above that I forgot to purchase. Because we need to have 3 ammo boxes just in case we need to resupply. Left or right, and the bottom, you see the bottom is almost empty, but we don't care, we have the ones above. If we have a normal tier 3 weapon, we wouldn't have any ammo box left from above. These 2 are actually the only doors I'm going to close, because I actually have visibility compared to this door and the others, and I don't want to invest there. So some more voltage grids, this can be quite interesting. And the others outside. After wave 9, wave 10, because we have the spare resources, we have to start applying these defenses. Because after that, we won't have the time. That's a big downside for being solo. You're alone and you have to apply all the defenses. So we will use every second we have available, as long as we have resources to spare, and apply defenses. They make a huge difference. Actually, yes, assault shotgun is better for me here, because in worst case scenario, I can switch to it and deal with the Zeke in close by, because the advanced combat weapon, that's the only downside. It deals damage to us in case we are in close range. So yeah, this one as well. And I'm going to buy one Voltage Grid just in case and start the wave. You don't have to save so much the resources, because as the game progresses, you won't have the time to apply the defenses. Especially if you were going for the long run. We'll be right back for defenses for wave 10. Moving on to wave defenses for wave 10. Ooh, still ammo. Now we actually have most of the things we want for the defenses here. Just checking on behind. But I think we're more than enough. The Zeke don't have a chance. Bam. When you have time and spare resources and all the defenses you want, just fortify the back a little more. Especially the barbed wires will make, once again, a huge difference for later waves. That's what we do basically for the long runs. We take advantage of every single second to apply all the defenses we can, because we won't have the time later. Actually, I'm lucky. I did a lot of the achievements and I have good points. I have the time to invest some barbed wires, even for this side. And I'm not sure what else I can deploy, because I think we have most of the things we need for the back, the turrets, and we also have here what we need for the voltage grids. Yeah, all the voltage grids. We have many things. We will apply this. Yeah, we can apply this voltage grid as well. You don't have to save points for defenses. The other thing you can do from this point on, if you have spare defenses, buy heavy weapons and supplies, especially if you have a DPS class that has grenades. Grenades, Molotovs, C4 make a huge difference for the DPS compared to now that we don't use the fixers. And that's why I said the fixer is a different class, because you can buy three times the tier 3 weapons. You can save an assault shotgun for this side and a long range weapon for the other side, and use a supply bag to refill them. So be right back for the next wave, that we will move to the other side. And we're done with wave 10. Sorry. And that's why I love the advanced combat weapon. Even with this least amount of ammo, we still got more than enough. And we still haven't touched so much the upstairs. Before we relocate, we're going to repair all the defenses. The fences and any voltage grids, but I think all the voltage grids are good here. So we're good to move to the other side, but before that, let's check out the back. We're still good. And I'm going to do something that I like to do sometimes. When I come in the back, just refill ammo. And just leave at least a couple of times for refill. As I told you, personally, 1 out of 5 or 10 times, I'm going to use the back. So, no, we're going to just not heal. Now, we're searching for the C4 once again. Be good lucky. We're not going to use it. We're just going to apply some extra defenses. We need to apply the auto turrets. Because I have extra points, I'm doing that. To apply even more defenses. Let's stock the ammo here. Die, dude. And apply some things here. The barbed wire, actually, very good. And, ooh, heavy weapon. Not the best, but it's a heavy weapon. So a barbed wire for here as well. We're going to pick up this heavy weapon, although it's not the best, but it can help close to the voltage grids. And we're going to apply some more defenses, definitely required for this side. Mortars. Three mortars are the best. This is one. Oh, I did a mistake. Thankfully, I have the time. I didn't apply the defense. Now, this is risky because in case you don't have the time to apply the defense and the time runs out, the bots can actually do a very stupid thing and go here, which has zero defenses, and it's a guarantee wipe for the bots. And if you are in a later wave, it's a probably wipe for you as well. So, three mortars. Sorry. Oh my god, yeah. I pressed E very fast. Don't worry. Now, I usually say that you have to carry the Voltage Grid, but up to wave 11, things are okay. So, I kill the Infectors there, because if they come here, the bots will jump down and suicide. Because they want to jump down to melee them, despite the number of Zeke downstairs. That's a very bad thing. And I think they're going to fix this in Aftermath. Hopefully. Because a very, very bad thing to do. Why go melee the Infector just inside the Countless Zeke? And one bot will go down that is trying to melee them. And another bot will go down to raise him and die. And the other bot will go down to save him and etc. So we're going to fire just a little before they are near the fence. I always like to shoot at least twice. That's why we don't stand close to the Voltage Grid. Exactly, this is the reason. Ouch. Because if you stay close, you can die. So we have to make sure to kill Eloise. Oh, have to shoot for mortar. No, we lost the fence. Anyway, we can kill Eloise. Oh, let's die bull. Oh, probably Eloise will die by herself. Because it will reset her health, and also if we heal her and goes down, she will die. That's why it's best. We can heal her after she is rest. Dude, we didn't kill Zeke with equipment because we don't have equipment. But we don't care. We can now go and breach this door. Always this door. Because for the other time we need to pick up the breaching charts. When we come here for the third time, I think in wave 20 or 18. We just need to breach the... Oh, I don't have a medkit actually. Why? I thought I had a medkit. That's strange. I was certain I had a medkit. Oh, I used it to myself because of a mistake I made. It took damage. Okay, okay. No worries. So we applied the fence. We are going to apply the fence so we can be outside. We also need two fences. Oh my god. The Zeke, as you see after wave 10, they get relentless. And they just can destroy the fences. And we also need to apply or stock from the inside. Sorry. And we need a Voltage Grid. Thank you, barbed wire. Going to see if we can do all the other things and leave the Voltage Grid for last. Because in worst case scenario, you can do it once the wave starts. Okay, good. We also need to do another thing. We need to apply a Voltage Grid here. Because in worst case scenario, in case the gate is attacked, we need to come here by ourselves and defend the gate. Oh, actually, we have defenses. And defend the gate. And we won't have any backup. The bots will stay here unless they see an Infector down. They won't move otherwise. So, yay. No, I'm not going to jump downstairs directly because if I do that, there's a high chance the bots will go there. But once the timer starts, they take the positions. We deploy the Voltage Grid and go. So we wave 12. Okay, Glimmer is not dead for some... Oh, it's dead. We need to kill as many Zeke as we can before they come close to the Voltage Grids. Otherwise, they can break them easy. Usually, I like this location, but it's very tricky. If the gas bugs drop, that's a bad thing. We can take unnecessary damage. See how many Zeke are coming. I hear the bomber, but thankfully, the auto turret just took care of him. So we killed, now what are they going to do? This is the best thing if the effectors can come close by, okay. So, we're going to kill as many as we can. And we're going to use the... Now, before they arrive to the fence, we need to fire at least twice. Kill as many Zeke as we can here. Oh, we have to empty the... Yeah, mistake. I should have fired the third time the mortar. No worries, because I want the fence to last. I think we have killed most of them. And good. Now, we're going to buy another supply crate for here. To resupply in between the waves. Once again. But this way you don't have to reapply other... Great, now let's have a look always at the turrets. The turret broke here. And the fences, okay. Turret and fence are good. I'm not going to invest more defenses here. I need to save some points for the other side. I'm just searching around now to see if I find a medkit. A proper heavy weapon. That after... Wave 15, you definitely need to always have a decent a heavy weapon with you in order to make things a little easier. But I don't think I have one. And yay. Not here, so we can start. Can we start? So, okay. For the mortars, if it has only one shot, you see how many shots it has from the right. You see this has one shot. This has two mortars. This has three mortars. So if it has one shot, use it. Don't save it to take the value. You won't have this time to do it after wave 13, 15. It's better to do it beforehand. And be careful if you begin the battle. Don't activate the mortar instead. I have done this countless times. Okay, this is another good way to wipe because... Sometimes the survivors will go down if they're nearby, and the bots will once again decide that they want to go to save the survivors. Okay, we need mortar. And that's very bad. Okay. Oh no. That's a very, 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 very bad situation. Now, I cannot defend the fences good, and a screamer spawned. This is why this can be a very bad scenario. See the screamer? Yeah, I saw him. But I cannot go and kill him because of the gas bug cloud. So thank you for that. Thankfully, once the gas is cleared. Oh, they broke the voltage grid. That was almost a wipe. We don't have any other voltage grid, so we have to make sure we don't break anything else. You see, even in wave 13, things can go a little harder. Oh, we can shoot the mortar actually, if you time it a little correctly, and shoot so many the Zeke without the fence. But yeah, the fence makes things much easier. I don't think, yeah, we don't have a survivor here, so we got very lucky. Oh no, we have to kill the infector. And to. Because the bots were going to just jump. We cover the survivors, very good for us. Very lucky actually. I have wiped so many times here because of the survivors in wave 15, 16. Because the bots decided to have a chain reaction and just die. But yeah, you have to be extra careful for the gas bag, for everything. Thankfully, the bots you see contribute a lot with the damage. You see the difference now, how many kills they've done. Okay, we need to repair everything we can before we relocate. Because now in wave 14, we relocate to the hangar. So we have to move extra fast. Did I see? Yeah, heavy weapon. I don't have the time to do that. Sorry. I will just take it later. I have to apply all the defenses. So I will be able to relocate to the hangar, search for the breach in charge, and we'll apply any other defenses we need. So, yeah, the zombie pervert is here. Bots, take care of him, please. Thank you very much. I'm searching for heavy weapons, medkit stuff. And I'm going to actually resupply from the back for some value. Ooh, medkit. I'm not going to pick it up yet because I think I remember another medkit from the hangar. And we will pick it up as we search for the C4. Oh, broken voltage grid. Okay. So let's start searching. Be careful of the lurkers. They have instant respawn and they can ruin your day. Here we can find a medkit, I think. Thank you for the medkit. And I'm going to heal Elois in case I find another medkit. Now it's good if you find the medkits to have your bots higher than 50% health. Just in order to make things easier. Yeah, we have to close this door. No C4. No C4, close the door. The door is closed, thankfully. And we have two more locations to search. Yeah, I heard the lurker. And I'm a little in edge. I think, yes, I have the time to find the breach in charge. No, it's not here. It's probably hidden in one of the libraries or it hasn't spawned yet. So I'll wait for to begin battle. I won't apply the voltage grid here. I'm actually going to save it in case any of the voltage grids here break during the wave and perform telekin strikes. Thankfully, we're getting the points. This is actually one of the easiest things you can do. Wave 14. Be careful if you come here, if the Zeke attack from here, it's very easy to die. So they're going coming from the middle. That's why I love the advanced combat weapon. In any range, it's effective. I hear bulls from behind, but I need to focus a little bit on everything. Thankfully, the bots with their tier 3 weapons make a small difference. Bull, just die. Where are they coming now from? I think from the right. Yeah, I think they're coming from the right. Yeah, if they drop from the... from there, from the roof, they're coming from the right. Here actually is a good location to start nuking because we have the voltage grid. But move inside, don't stay too long. And if they come close, just switch to the heavy weapon. M60 or heavy assault shotgun. And you can just kill them in close range. Oh my god, look how many. Yay, that's why I don't like to go above the wave 14. They come from two sides and it's impossible to keep track and kill them. Thankfully, we have so many defenses on the back that they won't be able to even touch our gate. So now where are they coming from? I think from the middle. I'm going to apply this voltage grid. And now start repairing the voltage grids. We have to take care of the back. To make sure all the defenses work properly. And actually, do we have there? Yeah, I have to actually replace the fence. I did a small mistake, so I'm losing some time. Okay. A lonely zombie here. Make sure all the the turrets are fully loaded. We are good. Lurker, no lurker. And we have to keep searching in case the C4 spawned. Because I don't see it, even in the libraries. Oh, yeah, full. Did it spawn inside here, actually? No. And yeah, after wave 15, we also defend here for wave 16. And then we have to apply the barbed wires. Although we can do it from now, if you have the time. A couple of barbed wires can make a small difference. Can actually make a huge difference, but... you have the time to also apply the voltage grids. Yeah. Outside. They're actually very helpful. Electro-grid is on. We didn't find the breaching charge yet. And I forgot to resupply, but that's why I'm going downstairs. Oh, no ammo left. That's strange. But we can resupply from here. I'm just not doing it because it's a risk for the bots to go there and there. And I just want all three of them in this location. It's the best default location for the bots. No equipment. Okay, that's a freebie. I'm not going to use equipment anyway. So they're going to come from the left, I think. When I say left, I mean here. Okay. Here is a nice location to go, but it's a little risky. Yeah, that's why it's risky. It can come from here. But if you are with teammates, this can be ideal. Very good for me. We're okay. Now we're from the middle. They're going to come. I need some ammo. And yeah, from there. This is actually very bad. They're coming from multiple locations. We don't have the time to keep up. That's why we had the defense outside. And after this, I'm going to purchase the soldiers. We need 4 soldiers. Definitely. Ooh, the gate got damaged. No, it didn't actually. It's very small. You don't have to run all the time. So they're going to come from the back. What the hell? Yeah, the bull. So they're going to come from here and here. I'm going to just thin out the herd. And I have to kill the ones that are coming from here. That's a bad thing now. Look how many they are. And you will see the difference. We kill at least 3 times the Zeke compared to the bots. Not only because we have the best weapon, we do better relocation. Yeah. Don't rush to the gate. Unless the durability goes even faster down. You still have some time and you can actually go here. You don't have to go all the way back. Here is a good location to come and nuke them. Yeah, all the turrets are offline. That's a bad thing. Sometimes it can happen because they didn't go down on the previous, let's say, here the previous run, but now it went down. We need to restock every single auto turret on the back. Repair the defenses. This is the hard part of the long runs, which that's why I don't really recommend. Some people like them. I used to like them. But I got tired every single time by doing these challenges. So yeah, I'm going to take a fence to repair here. Very good. You have to keep an eye to see what defenses are down. Yeah, I forgot I didn't see this one. To come back again. Basically, they make a huge difference, this on the back. And the barbed wires will also make a huge difference. So, I also need a medkit for Karim and myself. Ooh, 2 voltage grids are down. Okay. Thankfully, we have good points. That's why we don't close the doors now. No time. No time at all. Where is the vault at the medkit? It's on the right there. I don't think I have the time to go pick it up. So always prioritize defenses, whatever else you do. And yeah, we'll need to apply. Actually, I think I have the time to apply the barbed wire here. Go upstairs for the bots to be here. And then go buy a voltage grid just in case. Come up, guys. Thank you. Yeah, go buy the voltage grid just in case. Ooh, stationary machine gun. Oh no, I didn't buy it. Wave 16. They're going to come from the right, I think. And the middle, yeah, from the right. And from the middle, yes. So we're going to use the stationary machine gun. Kill as many as we can from the middle. After we have thinned out the ones on the right. So they're going to come from the middle, I think, two waves. So we'll take full advantage of the stationary machine gun. We're going to empty it, actually. It's not the best compared to the advanced combat weapon, but it's good to do the achievement. And to help us a little bit, save some ammo. And then they're going to come from the right, I think, again. And from the left and middle. Let's see. Yeah, they come from the right. You see the rooftop. From the right. Yeah, here the gas bag and everything. That's why I ran here. So we're going to use the advanced combat weapon. And when they come close, switch the M60. Be able to kill everything. You shall not pass. And yeah, from the left. Oh my god. M60, M60, M60. Oh no, it's M60. We need to take our distance. Oh my god. This is a small nightmare. Because as they run, they do damage, but we need to reapply the voltage grid. And yeah, kill those. Raul went down. Die, Raul. We are in the end of... Ooh, this is a bad screamer. Thankfully, we're just close by. Just die, dude. He's dead. Kill everything. And now, ooh, we need more voltage grids. Now we need to apply all the defenses before we relocate to repair everything. Because there is a chance to come back here. So we need to move fast, fast, fast. Especially the voltage grids are a huge priority. And we're going to go with the necessary voltage grids before we move to the terminal. And we're also going to apply some barbed wires because we have the time. And these barbed wires will make a difference in case we come back. But this is an optional, I don't know, some because we're going for, I think, wave 18. And we're going to chains. I'm not sure. So let's apply some barbed wires. We have the time. I need to pick up the medkit. But I think it's there. Oh, it's not here. I mistook the medkit location. So we're going on the back to make sure that all the defenses once again are proper. Now this is the bad thing. You see that the auto turrets are empty, are full. But in case of one attack, they will be empty. Oh, this is the medkit. Good. We're going to actually heal Karim. Because it's a little risky, you can heal yourself. Just prioritize the things. But you can also heal the bots. So we need to restock. Apply even better defenses for here. I won't go into search for the C4. Only if I have the time, because you need to prioritize the defenses. Things getting very hectic. I'm just checking here because it's very close by and it takes, I don't know, 30 seconds to check. We need to also restock. We need to also add some more defenses. You see things are hectic. Oh yeah, I need to resupply from here. And I also need the second very important auto turret here. See how, yeah, I need mortar. Because this mortar only has one shot. And I just need portage grid and we start. Capture the area. There's no possible way I'm going to do that after wave 15. So we need now to be careful for the gas bugs. And the infectors, yes. If they come close, it's good. If they don't, it's bad. At least to... Why is he charging? Okay. At least two shots with a mortar. Oh, yeah. That's bad. Be careful of this side. You see how many Zeke are coming. You have to switch soldiers, run. Oh dear. Oh dear. Look how many. Prioritize one side. Throw a couple of mortars. Start shooting. And we actually need to apply barbed wires. Ooh, we may need to refill ammo here. That's a bad thing. But things are okay for now. Oh, that's okay. Oh, gas bugs. They will come from upstairs, I think. I have lost so many, yeah. Oh no, it wasn't from upstairs actually. The bulls, oh no. Oh my god. The freaking husband just climbed upstairs and I did friendly fire to myself. But we're still good, we're still good. So we need to resupply. Do we have... Oh no, no, I hear a bull. It's going to break our voltage grid. Freaking bull. You don't have to, if you leave him, he will break the voltage grid. So let's search for a medkit. Sometimes it spawns here. As we search for... We apply for the defenses. I think they broke, yeah, they broke outside something. Good, and I think, yeah, I remember a heavy weapon there, actually. I'm going to grab. In a flash. Why are you going for me, Lurker? So many other potential... I don't know, snacks. Are you going for me? Why the hate? I'm going to search here fast, in case I found... Bridging charge or medkit? No, bridging charge or medkit. I'm going to have to buy medkits. Otherwise, we won't survive. You don't have to worry about that if you have plenty of resources. I'm just a little stingy with my supplies. Personally. And you also can buy heavy weapons if you have spare resources. And supplies. So let's see how our mortars are. Only one mortar. We have to replace this mortar. Because one mortar is not enough. Two mortars are the minimum. Kill any screamer. Have the voltage grid. Without voltage grid here can actually be a very easy wipe. So now it's up to you. Things are very hectic. Very one small mistake or misfortune if you get unlucky and you can be down. If gas bugs come from here, bad screamer. There are so many variables that can go bad here and it's a very easy wipe. So you don't have to take it personally. It's not your fault. It's just very easy to happen. And we're only 11-1, so we can do many things about that. We don't have upgrades. We don't have many things we can do. Let's see how much ammo we have here. Thankfully we had enough ammo, you see. That's why I love the advanced combat weapon. We got 57 bullets, which actually can get us through this whole whole wave. Ooh, they're coming from here. So this is our favorite spot. In the mouth. Good, in the mouth from here. I'm just saving the heavy weapon for the last possible minute that I will need it. Especially for the other side, it's better to have a heavy weapon. And we're okay for now. Oh yeah, we need the mortar. Oh no, I will shoot the mortar and leave. Fast. Yeah, here the freaking... You see, we cannot do anything about that. But we can just shoot the heavy weapon. Kill as many of the Zeke as we can. They can get by. The only thing we can do, honestly. Because this was unlucky, the two gas bags from above. I don't know. It's very unfair, honestly. I hope they fix this. Just gas bags running on top of you in random, let's say, random time. It's bad, to say the least. I think we can do it. Hey, we had ammo. Now we're going to see if all the defenses are good. I don't know if we will be able to come back, but anyway, we're going to apply and take advantage of the 30 seconds. Yeah, at least the two fences. Yeah, Lurker, okay. I hear you, you're here. You're scary. Two defenses at least. Restock the ammo from the auto turrets and go to the other side. I'll resupply from the middle, just in case, to save the ammo from the other locations. You see, I don't prioritize now the breaching charge, especially considering you will waste so much time to search for the breaching charge and breach the door. And time is precious. Precious. Actually, we have a couple of restocks here. In worst case scenario, but we're still good. If we find a medkit, we will heal Eloise, but we have a couple of medkits in the beginning. One more medkit, sorry, in the beginning. We can use. But for now, once again, we will prioritize a one voltage grid. And we definitely need to use the time to apply barbed wires. These are what will make a huge difference. For the defense, honestly. They slow down the Zeke enough. They kill a lot of Zeke. So these are what makes the difference. The bad thing, you need, you see how much time we need. Then 20 seconds to apply it and every one of them. So yeah, that's the only downside. So barbed wire, heavy weapons, get the assault shotgun, run up. This is a little risky. I'm going to apply the barbed wire after it starts. And I don't know if I have the time to get a voltage grid. So let's wait a little bit. No. I will actually go and buy a voltage grid. Just in case we get attacked. And get the MGL. It's better for now. In case they come here. So, wave 19. Things are very hectic now. Are they coming from the right? No. Are they coming from the middle here downstairs? Yeah, probably. No. Where are they? Very few here. From the middle at least. Okay. Infectors, you can ignore them if they're close by. Just move left and right to dodge the spit. Oh, they're coming from here, so... 1, 2, 3, 4 MGL and the rest with the advanced combat weapon. Just thin them out a little bit. And where are they coming from? From the right. Yeah, from the right. But not only here, they come from two locations. So they attack from the right and they can come from here as well, for example. That's a bad thing now. Yeah, you see. But we have the MGL. MGL 1. 2, 3, 4. Advanced combat weapon. Oh no, they break the fence. They broke the fence actually. Okay. We have to focus on the bulls. I have to actually resupply. It was a mistake, I didn't do it later. Yeah, that's why I love that mask combat weapon once again. You see, oh, I can actually go to the... But we wasted a lot of time and I don't know how much good we can do for this. Oh no, are they coming from here as well? Yeah, don't stand there. If they come from here, they can kill you. This is the safest spot you can see. My god. Look how many. If they come from the left or right, you have to focus. And thin them out. If they go in the back, you see we have the four soldiers, we have the two turrets, the voltage grids, many things. And not many resources. Here. Okay, we're okay for now, but we need to prioritize the defenses in front now, and just restock in the back. Because we need to have the time. Stock and everything. Voltage grid take highest priority. Then we have the barbed wires. That will help a lot. So voltage grid here. And let's find some barbed wires. I think we have time and resources. And I think they will attack from here, which a barbed wire will actually make a huge difference. If we have the time, you can do that. If you don't, just go with the voltage grids. Door I bother to close. And we have enough for one voltage grid just in case, which is good. This is what we need. I have the time to check here. No. Oh, yay. Breach in charge. I don't have the time to breach the door, but I can do it after the wave. So we're good. Also have a med kit. I don't know if I want to heal Eloise or the bots now. So I need to restock. And I think we have more than enough restock. Oh, no. This can be bad. Thankfully, all the bots came here. None of them gone there. And let's see where they're coming from, because I have no idea. I didn't keep my notes. Oh, from the middle. Are they also coming from the downstairs? Yeah. Prioritize a little bit there. You see they're coming from two or three directions at the same time, making it almost impossible to kill them all. Oh my god. Yeah, that screamer is there. Please set him up. We have to resupply each and every time we have the opportunity. Thankfully, we still have the other bug to resupply. Oh, they're coming from the right now. Yeah. Actually, we'll remain here. Kill as many as I can. And switch to the auto assault shotgun. The heavy assault shotgun. Oh my god. What the hell? The freaking bomber. Assault shotgun. Don't panic. Leave the bots to rest them one each other. Kill yourself. That's why we save this. And we're going to finish off Karim and Raul. I think we can do it before all the Zeke are dead. Oh, they come from there. Because I think they will come from there as well. We need to finish them off as fast as we can. I have to restock. Yeah. Things here, as you can see, extremely hectic. I think this is actually the last attack. So we can just kill Karim, which has the worst weapon. Kill as many Zeke as we can. Kill Raul, thankfully. Oh my god. Kill the big boy. Yay, we did it. And we can now only heal Eloise. Are they going to attack from here? I don't remember, actually. If they attack from here, we apply defenses. No. No more investing in defenses here. because now it's actually very, very bad. I don't think I need to restock here. I need to focus for this side. So, yeah, this can actually make a difference. Everything seems okay. Only one soldier dead. Searching for some supplies. Yeah, the shotgun is almost empty. We have actually the bridge in charge, which will make some difference. So we have everything here. We have a voltage grid. Yay. We also have the voltage grid, which is actually quite good. But we'll also apply now barbed wires, which I should have applied during the previous attacks. I just didn't have the time. But now we're going to breach the door. Go for barbed wires. Get the defenses. And thanks to the barbed wires, I think we can make it to wave 22, probably. But now every extra wave we do is a blessing, honestly. Things are not only hectic. It's a nightmare. An absolute nightmare. We can also apply the barbed wires on behind if you have the time, but we don't. Barbed wire deployed. And yeah, I'm not going to pick up the extra credits because we have more than enough for now. Go take the medkit, actually. Medkit, medkit, medkit. Resupply. We have to actually move very fast. Because if the time runs out and the boats go to the other side, it's probably a very bad wipe. We'll come here. The mortar, we need to replace one mortar. Replace one mortar, heal Eloise. And get the voltage grid. No, we don't care about that. We need everyone 100%. Because the boats are actually a huge help. Oop, that was a misclick. I didn't bought that, oh my god, so... prioritize this one, two, go for the screamer, one and three. You see how many Zeke are coming. Oh my god, look at this. We healed Eloise for nothing. Did it break? No, it didn't break actually. The one downstairs broken. There's so many, they can overwhelm the voltage screens from now on. Oh my god, I just remembered, I haven't restocked this one. That's a big bug. But I think I can restock in between. So don't forget to restock here. Like me. So we're actually going to restock now. Which is bad. Because we're now... Oh my god, why? Just kill him. Just kill him. Yeah, you see now how many Zeke are going to come. They can overwhelm us quite easy. And yeah, they broke the voltage grid. So thankfully I have a... Yay. You see one mistake now, it's very unforgivable. We have to kill those. We're not going for the gate. Because things are a little bad. Already here, we have to finish off everything here and then go for the gate. And actually how I usually lose, because I don't have enough time to defend the gate and defend everything. And even with a voltage grid behind us, things here are very bad because they will come from left and right, the Zeke. Yeah, I know the gates are under attack. I think we killed everything. But they're still coming, more waves. Which is bad. We need more voltage grid just in case. Yeah, we need to go back. Defend the gates. Once I... Oh, no, no, no. They're coming up from here. If I went there, close by, it's a wipe. I just have to go. Restock and go to defend the gate. And hope that the boats are going to hold. But yes. Usually if you have the supplies, they can make a small difference, actually. Now it's next to impossible to do the next the next wave. We don't have enough resources. We don't have enough defenses. It's literally a YOLO. And we cannot invest in anything. So probably that was it. But for the sake of argument, I don't like to give up that easy. So we'll try. I need to see to repair some defenses downstairs. Repair the fences. And we actually thankfully have 100% extra resources. So now we're not going to repair the fences there. We're going to leave them. Because first we don't have the time. We need to repair the gate, otherwise it's an auto wipe. And we need to repair the fences downstairs. So fences, repair the gate. You see we don't have enough things. And we also need to buy ammo. We're here. Oh, yes. And we don't have the time to do all the things. And we don't have... what we don't have? Yeah, we don't have for health. So yeah, with level 1 class, actually, after level 20, 21, it's actually so many XP that we'll get that we don't have to worry. So I'm going full YOLO, not going to repair this fence, and going fully to rely on my advanced combat weapon. Yeah, I heard the thank you for the gas bags. Because now I was going to use that, but I can't, thanks to the gas bags. That's why I think this is bullshit, to have gas bags drop from here. And I believe it's better to fix it and have no gas bags to drop from here. Outs. The voltage grid behind us failed. We have to repair it. Zeke are coming from here. And we died. We did the best we can, considering all the situations. We're level 1. But we don't have to worry. After wave 20, as I told you, every extra wave you do is a blessing. Even with fully leveled class, it's very hard to do it after level 21, 22, or 23. I have done, I think, 23 waves in solo. With a group, of course, you can do more if the group can coordinate a little bit better. And you see the difference. We did 7,000 kills. Karim had the advanced SMG and did 1,000. Raul did 1,500 and Eloise 2,000. So at least we get 24,000 XP. And from level 11, we went to level 24, which is quite good. We also got 4,880 yellow, 40 blues, and yay. So we're level 24. Something similar will bring us to max level for the fixer or any other class we were going to run. And yeah, you don't have to, for example, if you were in this situation as me, don't try the last wave if you don't have enough resources. If everything is broken, just quit out, get your points, don't waste your time and your sanity. And that was it for today's video. I really hope you like it and it will help you to just go through Horde mode to level up your characters in preparation for Aftermath or after Aftermath to even level up your Vanguard class, although I personally recommend to not invest so much time, go to 30-40 minute runs up to wave 13, quit out, play 3 times and you will get similar amount of XP without exhausting yourself mentally and literally. So feel free to like if you liked and you can subscribe to stay tuned for more upcoming videos for World War Z and other video games. And as always, I wish you all a wonderful day.